Scared money, make less of it. Don't ever let the chance pass you by. Just keep your eye up on the prizes. Life keeps spinning, these rules, I break them. Life keeps spinning, them risks, I take them. Runway to a
bed. This is Anthony with themovieblog.com, and I'm back here with another video. This time I'm going to be doing a quick review on this movie, Zone 414. Now, Zone 414 is the new action movie starring Guy Pearce and Matilda Ann, Anna Ingrid Lutz, and Jonathan Harris. Zone 414 is directed by Andrew Baird, and I caught this movie streaming on Netflix. Now, I'm always going to give a movie a shot if Guy Pearce is cast, so Zone 414 is one of those movies that caught my eye immediately. It's also sci-fi, and it takes place in a futuristic world where humans develop androids that really behave believably human. Diving right in, here's the good. Now, the story of Zone 14 isn't anything original, but the folks behind the movie, they put their own spin on a pretty by-the-numbers kind of story. Now, the mystery is of a missing girl, and there's a detective that's hired to find her, and that's something we've seen time and time again. Now, you add a futuristic setting and put Guy Pearce in the lead, that does make it pretty cool. The plot does take a few twists and turns, and it does like to play with our assumptions on just how predictable Zone 414 really is going to be. Here's a clue. There isn't one thing that I predicted that turned out to be true. The camera angles and the set design are really beautiful in Zone 414. There's a good layer of detail that looks authentic, and everything seems lived in. Doesn't give off that cosplay look that we've seen in some recent releases. Now, the pacing for Zone 414, that's nice. Something that worries me about mystery movies is that they can suffer from slow pacing. Now, Zone 414 does not get stuck in the moment. It doesn't get stuck at any one scene or anything like that, and it moves at a pretty nice pace. I love that. Now, of course, with any movie, there are some things that we're going to talk about that fall into the bad. Now, this story, unfortunately, can seem cliche. Little derivative, and that in and of itself makes it a little boring. I'd admit that I never really got invested in solving the mystery of this missing girl, and I really don't care why she wandered into this dangerous zone. The movie does try to subvert this expectation by instead asking us to focus on the world and the androids, and they have this thing about whether they're truly alive. Just kind of confusing. Are we looking for the girl, or are we trying to solve the mystery of androids? Like I said, this story can be kind of derivative, especially if you've seen films like it or TV shows like it. There's always those stories about whether or not cyborgs are real and how realistic are they and are they walking into the uncanny valley and all this great stuff. I really just wasn't into it. The performances in the movie didn't help either. Guy Pearce does his best to kind of sleepwalk through this one. He plays it by the numbers. Overall, it's actually a great streaming movie. It's something fun to put on in the background and passively watch. The movie does a pretty good job at letting you know when to look up and pay attention and when you can put your head back down. I'm giving this one like a 6.5 out of 10. If you guys have had a chance to see this movie, let me know what you think in the comments. Fun fact, I've never seen Blade Runner. So I get to view this movie with a different perspective than some. Again, let me know what you guys think in the comments. That's all I got for this one. I'm gonna check you guys later.